Okay, hello everyone, we're live. I always feel a little bit unprepared. It's always, oh, it's 8:30 in the morning, I have so much time, let's make coffee, let's let the ducks out. And all of a sudden, there's this crunch time 5 minutes before my wife just took the kids out the door and I'm saying bye out the window and I look and life goes on. So I'm happy you're here. Thanks for being here. I see lots of familiar names in the chat and some new names too. Hello everyone. Yeah, kind of, I was gonna say that music calms me down. I'm usually quick and jumpy, and I like that, and music, while still being quick and jumpy, it's just the accordion is therapeutic in that way for me. So we have about an hour today, as usual, and I'll mix it up. The same, if you have questions, type them in the live chat and I'll try and address those questions live. It'll be part performance, part explanation, and part answering questions. So yeah, thanks for joining. Here on the comm, yeah. Ford, congratulations on your new accordion, the concertina. Is that true where you have buttons on the left and the right and it's a different sound, like a harmonica going in and out? Is that called diatonic? Someone more informed, I'm sure, knows the answer. I'm just wondering. Hello, everyone. So many. So it's so nice. Oh, awesome. Alan, hello. You're planning on buying concertina too. Good. Good morning. I'm just looking and kind of saying good morning. I'm always amazed at the mix of countries and people that we have. So that's beautiful. Yes, Enemy Killer, let me know. Can I play something for you today? I'd be happy to. Let me know if you have requests. Type them in the live chat and I'll do my best to answer them. And yeah, Bella, for sure. Music brings people together. My joy is in playing with people. It changes the energy. And I think it changes my energy too, just the C minor, it just calms me right down. Let's play a C minor song. I'll play a song called Kol Dodi. It's a Jewish klezmer song. Kol means voice, and Dodi in a way means my beloved, so the voice of my beloved. This is a wedding song. Let's play it. Thank you. that's Koldo D, the voice of my beloved. Yeah, nice to see everyone here. A C minor tune. C minor, yeah, nice, a nice key to play in. Yeah, thanks for joining. I played that song. I did a play, like a stage show, in Toronto and Ottawa, for a few weeks, and that was a song that we sang with a clarinetist, and what else did we have? We had a drum and just people's voices, and as the song went la 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 da 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 da, and just the song picks up, and then we bring it up a key. Just a really fun tune. This song, as well as majority of the songs that I play on this live stream, are on my website, accordionlove.com, with chic music and explanations on how to play it. So let's... awesome. Good evening, Mia. Hello. From Clearwater, Florida. Hello, Ryan. And I saw someone from Northern Ontario. Enemy Killer, I don't know that song. You say it's a Ukrainian song. I can play lots of songs, and I'm going to do two songs now that I don't know how to play. We'll learn them together live. That one I don't know. Hello, Anne. Good. Let's, I wanted to do a little bit of an interactive session. And that's how, sorry, so two things. Someone sent me an email, a student sent me an email asking for the song Music and Friends. And so I thought, I didn't have time to reply to the student. And so I thought, let's learn it together quickly. And then another song that came on my YouTube playlist was, Hey, Good Looking, Hey, What You Cooking? And I thought, that's another easy to learn song, and I thought I would take 5 minutes and play it through together. And if you have your accordion, I'll say the chords, I'll play, and then the 2 second delay between me playing and you playing, I won't be able to hear you, but if you wanted to chuck along, you could. So let's try that. When figuring songs by ear, how do you detect the chords and chord changes? Let's do that right now. So I'm going to, I don't know if I need to share my screen. I'm looking, I'll show you my screen. I YouTube the song Music and Friends. I listened to it when the person sent me the email to say, this is doable. So MS711 and everyone else, I'll show you how I figure the song out by ear. I'm choosing the song now because I think it will take 5-6 minutes. It's not a difficult song, which is why I'm choosing it. So I'll stop sharing, but that's the song that I'm playing.
I've done a lot of living and I found.
And I found. Right, I don't know the words, but ba da da ba. I'm trying to match what I hear to the chords. Da da da. There. And
I've done a lot of living and I found.
And I found her and I fell. I wound up on the D. How did I do that? I have ear training exercises on my site, but years of ear training exercise. If I have my accordion now and you have your accordion and I do this, you can/should be able to play that back. With your accordion, you should be able to find that. So listening to Music and Friends, da da da, I hit the D. What chords contain a D? A D major, a D minor, a G major, right? It's a variation of a G. And what else has a D in it? A B flat, right? Those three chords have the D note in it. Now, listening to this song.
Done a lot of living and I found.
I'm going to try the D here. Found. There it is. One of the main chords in the song is a D major. Good. I'm just going to look at the chat to see if everyone's following and able to hear. Good. No one's saying we can't hear you. So I'm just going to keep listening. I know that one of my chords in the song is a D. there are things, this is MSM 11, there are things called song forms, popular chord changes in songs. If my main chord in the song is a D, and I understand that this song is simple, straightforward, popular folk, then likely the chord changes that the D is going to go to is either above the D on accordion, which is the A, or below the D on the accordion, which is a G. So the two chords that I'm going to listen for now and try and hit are either the A or the G. The likelihood, the probability that a song in D will go to the A or the G is something like 40 or 50%. So let's listen.
No matter where you go, the old world round.
That fits. So I'm just trying to... Ba, 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 ba. They're singing in D major. I'm just listening and playing along. Just the D major. Ba, 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 ba. A. Ba, 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 ba. Or just with left hand. Let's do that part again.
They always go to town. I've done a lot of living and I've found.
There, right? D major to A major to D major. Doesn't matter about the oom-pa-pa, it could just be da 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 da. D major to A major. I'm gonna listen a bit and play around, but I know that two of the chords are D major, A major, D major. It might go to a G major, but again, we're just over here. That's the beauty of the accordion. We have a D, the chord next to it, A, D major.
No matter where you go, the old world round. They always go together hand in hand. Where there's one, there'll be the other, music and friends. When blue skies turn to gray and hide the sun.
I know that there are three chords in the song. There might be a chorus, but I know there are three chords. How do I learn the song then? And right now I'm partially replying to my student. I would sit there and make sure you know your D, your A, and your D. Play it in tempo. You don't need the sheet music. If you want, if it helps, write down D, A, D, and then a G as well, and just go between those chords. Slowly. If you can switch smoothly, practice your switching. But D major to A major to D major. This student wanted to sing along with his friends the song Music and Friends. That's left hand. Right hand, learn your D major. How do you make your D major? Good. Learn how to switch to the A major to D major. And that's your right hand exercise. Depending on what skill level you are, you might just need to land on the D major without looking. Take your hand away. That's the exercise for today. It could be switching. Back and forth. Learning a voicing that's easier to switch to. And then putting them together. Pa 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 pa. Right? And then I would just play along with the song. So I'm going to take a minute to play along to the song, and this is what I would do. Beginning, sorry.
I've done a lot of living and I found. No matter where you go, the old world round. They always go together hand in hand. Where there's one, there'll be the other, music and friends. When blue skies turn to to gray and hide the sun. When tired hands their daily work has done, nothing seems to turn things round again and make the old world right like music and friends. Music and friends, it's so good to bring together music and friends. Side by side, no one can break them when we take the...
Anyways, but that's how I learn a song by ear. How I figure out a song by ear is figure out that first chord, figure out which chord that is, figure out the first note that I hear, figuring out which notes that is, and so figuring out the chords, and then seeing where those chords move. Majority of the time, it's based on a popular song form. Let me go back to the actual chat. Let me know if that's useful. Good. That's a song, Music and Friends. Yeah, aren't we lucky we've got Music and Friends? I haven't heard that song before. But that's how I would go along. That's how I learn songs. Whenever I've been in bands, the band leader will come with a song and say, hey, the song goes from G minor to D to G minor. And then we're all sitting there with our instruments going. Yeah. Got it. If I speak and there's music on my computer, we don't hear you. Totally understandable. That makes sense. But yeah, that's the idea of playing music. Whatever skill level you are, your practice will change depending on what that is. But the point that I'd love for you to get to is for me to say, hey, we're going to play Music and Friends. It's a D major. Hold it for a bit to A to D. And for you to go, oh, D major. Ba, 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 A to the D. For me to say, yeah, that's cool. Let's go through that. Ba, 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 da. Right? If you've been involved in song circles, someone will bring out a song. I love this method because you're not sitting there looking at the sheet music necessarily. You might have a little chart that says D, A, D for the verse. But your head's then looking up. And then when you go to the chorus, you can sort of look up and nod and see that. Good. The song forms are based on the genre of the song. Yes. All of the music. Yes and no. Introduction to song forms. There's a really nice... This is the 1-4-5, right? There are different song forms. The minor sixth. The minor sixth is like, I heard there was a secret chord. That's the minor sixth from the one. There's the minor four, right? There's all sorts of song forms, and depending on how you connect them, the genre of music will... to answer your question, the song forms will change on the genre of music. Tango, let's say. D minor. Well, you choose our minor one. D minor will most likely go to the 5 or the minor 4. So again, we have that 1-4-5, right? Still minor 1 to the 5. Right? Thank you very much, Larry Thibault. That's very kind. Thank you, Larry. If I'm playing a klezmer song, klezmer, Balkan, has a very specific song form. From my D major, let's say. It's going to go to the minor 4. Or another kind of klezmer that we see in Miserlou. Right? It goes... So becoming familiar with song forms, if you're in a klezmer band, you have 2 or 3 song forms. It means that if a song's an E major, 90% of the time you're hitting the A minor. Same as Balkan a little bit. If you're playing swing, big band, that kind of music, that's the song Hey Good Lookin' by Hank Williams, right? Hey, good lookin', hey, what you cookin'? That C major to D major, that's a real popular chord change. So I think it's similar. I always make bad analogies. It's similar to cooking. When you're working with dough, there are four or five things. There are four or five principles that are common, right? You should mix your wets with your dries. My wife would yell at me. There's a way of folding dough, right? My wife makes sourdough and she has a certain methodology. And once you are able to do those, once you're familiar with those principles, anything you pick up, whether it's pizza or a baguette or cookies, you can follow the recipe and say, oh, okay, I'm folding here, I'm letting it rest here, and I'm mixing here. Similar with music, we have those five or six musical principles that, depending on your musical style, but in general, popular music follows those five or six principles that you'll be able to start picking them up. You'll be able to start hearing them. Yeah, I call them song forms, and they are on Accordion Love. Awesome. Voilà, Monsieur Thibault. Okay, good. Let's play more music. Hello, hello, Lynn. Someone made the comment last time. We have 50 viewers and 9 likes. If you can hit the like button, I think it helps. I think it puts I don't know what it does. It tells YouTube that this is a worthwhile live stream and it might show up on other accordionists' streams. Yeah, Douglas, I have the song forms on YouTube. I'll show you a cool tool. Sorry, I think this is what these live streams are for. I think that they're for dialogue. I'll show you a cool tool. Where is my song forms? On lesson one. Is it on lesson one? Sorry, there's a really cool tool. There's a great website that's called the Music Probability Chart. Douglas, I don't have a cheat sheet, but I'll show you a really cool tool. There it is. Hooktheory.com/trends. I'll share this. I'm going to paste it into the live stream just for people to look at later. I suggest you stay here. Where is it? Okay, so an awesome way to explore chord progressions. This shows you the probability of chord changes. So you choose your key. Our song is in C major, right? Music and Friends was in D major. What are the likely chords that are going to change from D major? From D. So from a D major, here's the probability of what the song will change into which chord. From a D major, the song is going to change to A major 25% of the time. That's Music and Friends. The rest of the time, 19%, it will change to G major. This is how I use the tool. I think the tool is, if you're in D major, here are the songs that are I was crying when I left you, now I'm, or I don't want to miss a thing. So in the song Crying, yeah. Sorry, I'm just reading. Got it. So you could choose your chord progressions. The song Crying by Aerosmith starts in D major. 25% of songs go to A major. So if we click A major, maybe that's not how we use this tool. Got it. I guess it shows the chord progression of certain songs and the probability of a chord going to those songs. How I use this tool is whatever chord I'm in. If a song's in D major, again, 25% of the time it'll go to the A, which is called the 5 chord. 19% of the time it'll go to the G. Sometimes it'll go to other chords. Totally cool. And there's some other chords that it might go to as well that you can drill down into. And this works for any key. What song are we playing? Yeah, that's a cool tool. Hook theory / trends. What are the trends in music? And again, these are popular songs. But Douglas, I would love to make more of a cheat sheet. Yeah. And I, Bella, I know that song. I've never played it. I've actually never seen The Sound of Music. I'm going to play another song. I'm going to play Viva Dry from Cirque du Soleil. A song that doesn't follow any of those forms. Viva Dry from Cirque du Soleil. That's another song that I like to start with that's unobtrusive. It draws attention, but it's not a huge song. Hello, Alan from Mexico. I hope everyone is staying safe wherever they are. Yeah. Did everyone catch the Cotati Music Festival last week? That was, it was unreal the way that those musicians perform. Thank you. I wanted to play Unchained Melody again, because that's a nice song. Yeah, Anne, you told me about it.
Thank you.
Sorry, I'm confused by the song. Could you make a lesson on pulling ninth chords on the bass, or an easier way to play chords that are too far away in an easy manner? Alan, let me... What are ninth chords? I'm not sure what a ninth chord is. I understand ninth on the right hand. What's a ninth chord on the bass? And then I guess let me know of a big chord jump on the left hand. The biggest chord jump that I think you can do cleanly for popular songs that I see are, let's say, an E minor to an F. Is that a ninth? If that is a ninth, there's this shortcut, right? There's the E to this F. Right? Versus doing this. If you're on Accordion Love, I call it a half-step bass jump. Because we're going a half-step up. Which I realize is a ninth. Yeah, I can play Vals d'Amélie. Sorry about that Unchained Melody. Yeah, let's do Vals d'Amélie in a different key. C minor.
Thank you.
It's a really, really nice set of chords. I saw what Douglas said there, which is, I found that people identify with small pieces and patterns, then are free to express yourself between, which is why improvisations are so cool. Yeah. Jan Tiersen especially, and I know Douglas, just from exchanging emails with you, you figure that out, right? I've did a series of lessons about the melody is hidden within the chords. So Jan Tiersen chooses three or four chords. I switched it to F minor, but let's switch it to D minor. Amelie theme song. D minor to A minor. And then he does F to C. Right? Is that what he does? Yeah. Ba-da-da-da. So D minor to F minor is this. And any white key that you play fits. It's a safe key to play. So what Douglas says is any combination of things that sound good. And that's what I'm doing. I'm figuring out the key. I switched key to make my fingers learn new pathways. I played at an F minor, right? And so what sounds nice there? Yeah. My song, right? It's my D minor to my A minor with twiddling my fingers a little bit. Figuring out, like Douglas says, a nice pattern. People identify with small pieces and patterns. So well said, Douglas. Thank you. Thank you to everyone. Thank you, Mia. Thank you to everyone that's commenting. The chord options in Stradella bass system are bigger if your dominant seventh chord row doesn't also sound the fifth of the chord. I didn't know that could be an option. I've seen people with different buttons here, and I'm assuming that can connect or disconnect what sound gets expressed out of the chord. With practice, this comes. With specific practice, there's... Who was it? Keith Jarrett, when he did the Cologne concert in Cologne, on solo piano, he was so hesitant about transcribing it. Keith Jarrett is piano superstar, but I'm assuming part of what he was doing was it was that performance. So for me to note, I'm not comparing myself to Keith Jarrett, I'm making the analogy, which is for me to notate what I just played, it's so much, I encourage you to learn the F, the chords, right? The D minor to A minor, the F to C. It's going to be so much easier for you to play variations on that than what I played exactly. I think there were parts in there that would be worthwhile notating. I was up here for a little bit and it sounded nice to play. Sure. But this part, the part that went, I think you'll have an easier time, a musician will have an easier time to say, oh, he's hitting a D minor to an A minor, rather than reading the sheet music and saying, oh, okay, is that an F to a C? It's kind of like explaining, back to that cooking analogy, how to fold dough and how to mix ingredients together. You don't have to say, okay, right hand over left hand. In the beginning, sure, you need someone to show you those things, but this is, I guess, Mia's comment. With practice, we'll do the same one day for sure. But start stepping away from the sheet music a little bit at a time. Use sheet music as a reference. Use the recipe card to say, okay, right hand over left hand over right. But then turn away from the recipe card, turn away from the sheet music and say, can I do it? And it's a scary thing for me to step away from the written instructions when it comes to cooking. Can I play La Noyer? I think I just played La Noyer. You know the song from Adele, Someone Like You? Oh, my wife listens to that. Never thought I'd find someone like you. Let me listen to it very quickly. Someone Like You by Adele. I think it's a song. My thing is, you can play a song if you know the song. I don't know the verse. I think I know the chorus.
I heard that you're settled down, that you found a girl and you're married now. I heard that your dreams came.
I don't know the song. Like, I could do a... I can play the chorus. So John and Nikolai, I think. So do I have tips on memory buildup? Trying to get grips with Pink Martinis, the Lemonade song, using the app Perfect Tempo to slow it down. Would love to hear you. Yeah, I'll give you some suggestions. I don't have a clear mind when it comes to music recall because it's been a while since I've learned how to recall music. But I'll give you a similar analogy with judo, with martial arts. But with music, I created a series of lessons called Ear Training Exercises, Accordion Love, hand-ear coordination exercises for the accordion. So what this is, I'll share the link. Scroll down. I do the ear exercises with my wife, who doesn't play music, who doesn't know keyboard. Ear training exercises are this. Am I still on camera? Yeah. I encourage you to take your accordion. This is how I teach music, and this is how I teach other musicians, and other musicians teach me. And I play a series of notes, 3 to 5 notes, like this. Don't look. Again. And you would take your accordion after I play twice, and you would play that back with nothing in between. So that's all you hear. Do, 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 do. And they get gradually longer and harder. But again, the maximum number of notes that I could recall is like 8, right? So something like this. Again. Do, 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 do. There's a little trill in there. So you would build up to that. And then I learned songs that way. So at the bottom of this page, I have 9 exercises. They sound like this. And again. And I'll do it live. I think it's in C. Oh. And if you look at the video of my wife doing it, and even me doing it, I get my 5-year-old to just play random notes, and I play them back. And just like I did now, we miss the note the first few times. We might need to play the exercise back, but eventually you get it. And what I hope this encourages, I don't provide the sheet music on purpose, is you got this. These musical phrases, you can play. And there are more exercises too. Over here it says, get 14 free exercises. There's no email or anything. For some reason, I made it on another website. So 14 more exercises. And so that's the training part, to answer your question. That's the training part of training your ear to memorize small musical phrases. What I then encourage is... How to play and memorize your first accordion song by ear is another. These are all free resources. You don't need to be a member. Is how to learn a song. And learning a song. Sorry, let me. I'll paste this link in the live stream. How to memorize songs. I think I say 30 or 40% of song memorization comes before you even touch your accordion, and it's knowing the song. That Adele song I can't play, even if I pull up the sheet music, I won't know the song because I don't know it. I can't sing the song back to you or hum it back to you. The chorus I think I know, right? Never thought I'd find someone like you. Yeah, I know the chorus, but I don't know the song. I can't start learning Adele's Someone Like You because I haven't listened to it enough. So I think, to answer your question, I have huge recall. Let's say part of it might be innate. The other part is I try not to learn songs that I don't know. It takes me, let's say, if X is the amount of time that it takes me to learn a song, this is the graph. 30% of that time is me listening to the song on repeat for that, you know, 30 over X. For 30% of the time, I'm learning the song. I'm listening to it, not even touching the accordion. Only once I'm able to sing it back, that's when I pull up the sheet music, the chord chart. That's when I could say, oh, that's where the chord changes. So I think ear training exercises in combination with knowing the song will help your song recall. I could pull up a sheet music now to a song. Even if I knew how to read sheet music by heart, I'll be able to play the song. But for me, the expression won't come out. I won't know the song. It's like me making a recipe. I can make a recipe, but if I don't do it 10 times, 100 times, and start to step away from the recipe, I won't know that recipe. Good. And Anne said, yeah, that I'm doomed. I'm a recipe follower for a sheet music reader. Totally. I was going to do a martial arts example. When I did judo before this physical distancing, watching my teacher, my sensei, do a move, there were so many things to remember. It was turning the wrist this way, pulling, but not like that, like pull like that, bring my body in, turn, this is judo, and then come under and do the turn. And watching my sensei do it, he did it. And he did all those 15 steps easily. And for me, as he's watching me do it, he's like, oh, yeah, and turn your wrist. And I'm like, oh, and I forgot to bring my body in. And here, my wrist needs to be like that, not like that. And my shoulder needs to be down. So I think, again, repetition, practice. And with that, will come an increased memory recall. Part of it is knowing it. Part of it is doing it 100 times. Scrambled eggs, I don't need to look at the recipe anymore. The first few times I did it, we had to do it. I remember watching Jacques Pepin debone a chicken. Me and my wife, last time that I spoke about that, people didn't like it. But anyways, we deboned our chicken. And man, oh man, it was just play and pause and play and pause and watching him do it. And now it's a little bit smoother. We're not Jacques Pepin, but we've become better at doing that physical exercise. And music is partially a physical exercise, partially a mental exercise. Good. I see there's comments. I hope you... and Doug says, you're not doomed. You have valuable skill. Now play with the rest and like a bird, fly free. Wonderful. Good. And I think Someone Like You is a beautiful song to play. My accordion teacher as well. It's really a challenge for me. I have a long way to go, but I'm making progress. Baby steps. Yeah, my old piano teacher, when I took lessons, a part of the... So my 15 minutes of exercise that I recommend, my piano teacher would always do ear training exercises. It was my favorite part of the lesson because I didn't have to read sheet music. And she would sit there and play... And I would have to play, you know. So incorporate those ear training exercises as part of your exercise. And one last word is when I teach a lesson on Accordion Love, in the winter I wear it. What song? Your song, Elton John. We'll pull that up. Oh, it's a beautiful song. When I do the lesson, I incorporate playback exercise. So the sheet music is there, right, with the chords and all of that stuff. What I encourage you to do is to watch the performance, but then to do the lesson. Because what I say is the song's in E flat, and then it goes to A flat. And then we'll do the playback. I'll say... So I teach music through that playback exercise, and I think it'll help your memory recall. Good. That's all I'm going to say about that. It's a wonderful topic, though. Maslow stages of learning. Ricardo de Judo analogy. I'm assuming he did the same thing, right? He did the series of needs. Your song. Oh, man. I'm going to pull up the sheet music. Is that cool? I'm going to use sheet music. I'm just going to pull it up. D major. Okay, let's play it. Your song has been requested. I apologize if... just what's that chord? And you can tell everybody. Give me 1 second. The song's for you. The song's for you. B minor. I'm going to try and play the song. I'm playing this Your Song by Elton John off of sheet music. This is really rare. Thank you. get the sheep music? Song. I don't know if you're on YouTube sometimes, but on my feed, I've been watching Elton John, and there was the 1980 or 1981 his concert from Central Park, and he plays your song wearing a duck costume. What a talented guy! What a character! We're lucky to be living at the same time as Elton John. Beautiful song. That song I would play with singing, right?
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. Not one of those who can easily hide. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. And you can tell everybody this is a song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind that I put down in words that one.
Yeah, I think that works really well. Yeah, so the song is on Accordion Love. What I felt as I was playing the sheet music, I thought there were tricky parts in the song, and the sheet music helped me through those tricky parts. But then, obviously, I played the song a few months ago, and so this was just a quick recall with the sheet music. And once I stepped away from the sheet music, I felt like the song was more my song. My song. Awesome. Let me just go through some of the chat. Great. Yeah, there's sheet music. I know, right? I looked at sheet music. Hello, Andre. Thank you. What a nice song. Your diversity continues to amaze and entertain. Thank you, Janice. Thank you, Douglas. Totally unnecessary, but thank you. Vintage Elton John. You saw him in the 70s. Oh, my dream. Nice to finally catch you live as I'm on the other part of the globe. Thank you, Andre. Andre, are you from Romania? I'm assuming, maybe? Your playing's awesome. Go bless the whole nation to take five and listen to you, all of us at the same time. Awesome. Larkfest, they called sheet music the dots. Yeah. Super useful. Dots are really useful. Now I feel like playing more Elton John. Elton John, yeah. Beautiful music. Hello, Moses from Germany. I feel like playing, we do karaoke at home in the backyard because our neighbors aren't very close, and we have a karaoke machine set up, YouTube and microphones, and I always play, what's that song by Billie Eilish? So my wife goes, oh, you should sing the song, what's that song called by Billie Eilish? I could say I like it, like it, like it, like that. I don't know what the song is called, but she goes, you should sing it. And I said, there's no way I could sing it. But I sat down on the piano and played it, and it's a beautiful song. So I'll play it on accordion. I saw some questions for song requests earlier that I don't know, which is why I didn't do them. But I'll play Billie Eilish's, I think it's called, it's not called I Like It Like That. When the Party's Over, yes. Thank you, Ford. The song Daniel by Elton John. Is that true? Daniel Elton John. Song. I'm sorry. Let's do this game that Nick asked about. Hey, Ronan, how about you play a chord progression and we guess the song? Oh, man. Nick and Lindsay. This is a tough one. Let me see if you can guess it. It's probably the same chord progression as like 1,000 other songs, but see if you can guess it. I'll try and play it in a rhythm. Tiny Dancer is a beautiful one. Yes, was that easy? It's hard for me to play it because part of me wants to play the melody. That was Hallelujah. Good job. I'll do one that's a little bit harder. This is going to be the chorus of a song. I don't play it, but I think it's what's in my head. guesses. It's a duo that sings the song. That's the instrumental. This person gets the news they need on the weather report. I get the news I need on the weather report. Half of the time we're gone and we don't know where, we don't know where. The only living boy in New York. It's a beautiful song by Simon and Garfunkel. Tiny Dancer is another beautiful one, right?
Seamstress for the band.
It's a beautiful song. I know there. It's yeah, Simon and Garfunkel, Only Living Boy in New York. I heard my wife come with the kids. One of them might be standing outside my door, so I'll play a few more songs. Thank you, everyone, for coming out. It's always seems so short, and I remember looking down. It's like, oh, it was already 27 minutes into the live stream. We don't know the song, but this was so fun. Yeah, I like it. Let me do one more. And then I'll play some songs. If you have questions I didn't get to, my email is ronan@accordionlove.com. Let's do... Obvious. That last song sounds like a tarantella. It does. Yes, Yellow Submarine. Good job, James Pierce Photography. Yes, it was like a. We all live in a yellow submarine. A yellow submarine. A yellow submarine. Yes, well done. I'll play Forest Flowers. I'll play tarantella. Yes, let's do a tarantella to Forest Flowers to whatever people request. We'll be right back. almost worked out. It's so good to play songs that are slow. I like playing as, right? That's like musical ADHD, but it's just like little bits of it. It's kind of fun. Or playing very fast songs, very slow. Someone had a question. I've been playing for accordion for 3 years. Do you recommend any good books? Crazy D, I guess, depends where you are. Is there a specific genre you want to learn? I guess depends what your skill level is. You could be playing for 60 years. For me, who's been playing accordion for a while now, the books that I would recommend to myself is, am I trying to learn jazz? In which case, I would pick up a jazz book that just shows me what the chord progressions are for jazz. I guess, what are you struggling with and what are you trying to go towards? And then pick up those books. If you want to play ragtime, pick up a ragtime book with songs. I guess after 3 years, maybe it's more song books rather than theory books. Or if you're, my suggestion is to pick up a piano book or to have a few lessons with a piano teacher sometimes. Usually the right hand is what needs work. Left hand, if you're playing classical or you need to learn really the stradella bass system with scales, sure, get a book. But majority of the things on the left hand for me, I know I'm limited in a way, but I could play the left hand various rhythms. Now it's more, how do I do different voicings, different triads? Maybe it's... maybe it's certain things that you're trying to learn. I like fast-moving polkas and stuff like that. Yeah, pick up a polka book and play your way through it. And when you, if let's say it's your speed, right? You're like, hey, I understand that beer barrel polka is... but you find that you're lacking in speed. Maybe it is just playing scales, right? Maybe it's doing scales. If you like fast chord changes, pick up a polka book. I don't have too much more input. But yeah, whatever that you want to play, pick up a book on that. Do all piano keyboard sizes, white parts on accordion, all the same or variable? This key size, I think this is a ladies accordion because the keys are quite small. I'm sure there's a width of measurement. My newer Weltmeister accordion, I think, is not a women's accordion, and so the key size is bigger. I enjoy the small key size. It means that I could play big octaves. I've never played this octave, but I can, right, do these crazy chords. But otherwise, the key width can be different. I think there are probably two or three key widths, and the number of octaves also varies. So this is a three octave. We have F to F, F to F, 2 and 3, and a little bit more. Bigger accordions will have a bigger keyboard. Same as the number of bass buttons. We usually say it's 120 bass, or 96, or 72, or 60. Will also vary in how many octaves there are. I'll play one more tango. Cumbia. I still don't know cumbia music. Thank you. push it up. That up from G minor to A minor. It sounded really cool. Let It Be, I would play. Yeah, play around with Let It Be. Wherever you're stumbling, let it... I guess, where are you stumbling with Let It Be? The chords are straightforward, right? C major, G major, A minor, to F, C, G, F, to the C. Make sure you know all those chords. Are you trying to sing along or play the melody? If you're playing the melody, just play the melody, right? So pinpoint where you're struggling and then concentrate your practice on that. If you're singing, when I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me. That's a huge jump from the A minor to the F. If that's where you're stumbling, practice your incremental bass jumps. Anyways, that's the time we have for today. Thank you for sticking around, and thank you for everyone for showing up. I'll see you next Sunday. I hope you're well. Thank you.